Hey, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I wanted to talk to you about GitHub pages and specifically getting rid of that username.github.io URL and putting a custom domain name in front of it. Now, this will work for any domain registry. I happen to use Godaddy, so if you're using Godaddy as well, these are the exact steps that you have to follow. If you're not using Godaddy, use the same steps with your own register. So here's my Pickering is Springfield website hosted on GitHub pages. You can see pickeringisspringfield.github.io. And I don't want that GitHub pages URL. I want this URL, pickeringisspringfield.com, which is hosted on my GoDaddy account. So how do I do that? Well, what I do is I go into my project. The user account is Pickering is Springfield. And of course, for GitHub pages, it has to be your username.github.io as the name of the repository. You can see that just listed there in my list of repositories right here for my Pickering is Springfield account. Now, the first thing you need to do is go to settings. Now, by the way, notice I'm in main. That's a new twist. They no longer put these on master by default. Anyways, I'm going to settings for this repository and I'm scrolling all the way down to custom domain under GitHub pages. And you notice nothing is there. I am going to paste in pickeringisspringfield.com. That is the name that I've registered and exists right now over on GoDaddy. Now, when you do that, something happens. If I come back to my Pickering is Springfield repository, you'll notice this file named CNAME. You can see that file, and it has the name pickeringisspringfield.com. That's why they call it CNAME. If you see that file, you'll see your domain name inside of it. Okay, that might not be why, but it sounds good to me. Anyways, that's sort of the razzle-dazzle that happens on GitHub on your repository side. Now, to configure your domain name here over on GoDaddy, you actually have to go to GitHub and find out what the IP address is to use for Apex domain names. And here it is right here, configuring an Apex domain name. That's your your big A domain. Now it says 185.199.108.153 is a valid A name record. So I'm going to copy that. I'm going to go to my domain manager. I'm going to find Pickering is Springfield and click on manage DNS. I will look at the A name entry for the DNS. You can see it's just looks like a loopback or something like that there. And I'm going to put in, or a mask, I'm going to put in what they told me to put in from GitHub. Again, that's on the docs.github.com. I'll put a link in the tutorial description, and it's got a number of different IP addresses to choose from. Now that's part one. Also notice the CNAME for www is godaddy.com. That's not gonna help. What I have to do is I have to come over to my domain and put whatever my GitHub pages URL is, pickeringisspringfield.github.io, and I have to change that www points to setting. I click save there, and now I'm done, although I will have to wait. These records don't get updated immediately. It might take an hour, it might take 24 hours, depending on your domain name and who's hosting your domain name. I think GoDaddy is pretty good. But just to review, before I give it a try, what I had to do was I had to go settings for my domain, go into settings, find that GitHub pages entry, set a custom domain, which then set up a file named CNAME in my project. Then I made sure that I had the right IP address from github.com, and I set that as the A name value, and then I made the name of the project, the name of the repository, the name of the base page, GitHub pages URL, the www CNAME, and that's everything you have to do to set up a domain name. Now, will this work? And there we go. Now my actual domain is working. Even if I click on links here like CanCon, you can see it's actually taking the HTML page, learn Java, similarities. You can see that it is now all working off my domain name, which is configured over here in GoDaddy. And there you go. That's how easy it is to set up a custom domain name for your GitHub pages. Now, if you enjoyed that tutorial, head over to theserverside.com. I'm the editor-in-chief over there. Got lots of great tutorials on that site about Git, GitHub, DevOps, you name it. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can always follow me on Twitter, @CameronMCNZ, and subscribe on YouTube.